because today is Acts Thanksgiving Day. Can you do it?
Amen.
Amen. You look around, look to the people in both of your sides, smile, say, I'm very happy to see you. Psalm 103 verses 1 until 5 says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. God's strict instruction to every human being that we are not to forget the goodness of God. We are not to forget His benefits. Look at you. You're so beautiful. Look at you. You're so attractive. Look to where you have gone this far. Where you have gone thus far. To how the Lord has blessed you. Can you still remember how you've been when you were 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15 years ago? To how the Lord found you, to how the Lord changed, transformed your life? God said we are not to forget His goodness. Amen? Forget all His benefits. King David continued on from verses 3 to 5 by saying, God Almighty, forgive all of my iniquities, all of my sins. He said, God Almighty, heal all of my diseases. Then he continued on, God Almighty, crown me with loving kindness and tender mercies. And he said, more, God Almighty, preserves my soul from evil. And then I like the number 5. Verse 5 says, the Lord fills my mouth with good things, that my youth will be renewed like the eagles. David said he was already old, but he still was looking young, because God keeps to fill his mouth with good things. What are your stories? What are the things you owe and you desire to thank Him this very afternoon? In a while, after we receive the Word of God, we will have our chance to do that individually, to be standing before God and to tell Him personally what are the goodness He gave into our lives. Amen? But before we go to such, I'd like us to understand that worship is actually Godward and at the same time to the brethrenward. I mean, up and to the side. Why up? Because our worship is totally addressed to God Almighty. But we cannot do such if we do not have good relationship with our brothers and sisters. The Lord said, when we say we love God but we hate our brothers, or we hate anybody, that anybody can be our neighbor, that anybody can be a friend, a classmate, or whoever. When we say we love God but hate another person, God said in His Word, you are a liar. Now tell someone and tell the brother, say, I'm not that liar. Come on. Amen, amen. So before we go and about to receive the Word of God, we have a special guest to be formally announced to us, introduced to us. But before that, I know we got like tight entire, the whole of our sanctuary this evening. But I'd like us ourselves to fellowship one another. Let's give ourselves the chance to exchange pleasantries. Can we all?
Chosen men of God willingly answered his call for the ministry during his junior years in college at the University of San Carlos while he was taking BSECE. He changed course from becoming an engineer to nurturing God's people. Instead of exploring the world at 19 like most teenagers do, he started his first formal spiritual training at the Spiritual Renewal Bible Institute in Cebu City. At a very young age of 21, he got his pastoral appointment, and from then on, he wholeheartedly followed God's leading. God gave him a wife at the age of... being sensitive to the spiritual needs of the flock and trusted to their care. In return, he was blessed with more trainings both here and abroad, twice in Australia, in Singapore, and just recently in Maui, Hawaii, where he further developed his leadership skill at Hagai Advanced Leadership Training Institute. Our speaker has been nurturing God's people for 33 years in various places, His first 4 years was spent in Lapu-Lapu City, Cebu. The next 4 years was devoted to the flock living in the heart of Cebu City. God led him from Visayas to Mindanao, where he was assigned in Iligan for 4 years. He is now in his 21st year catering to the spiritual needs of God's people in Cagayan de Oro City. This dedicated man of God is the Bishop of the Jesus Christ is Lord Fellowship End Time Harvest Ministries, with over 66 satellite churches and outreaches nationwide, 2 churches in Australia and 1 in Kota Kinabalu, Malaysia. His union with Ayana May Avellanosa is blessed with the 4 fruits of their love, Kish at 14, Kate at 12, and the 10-year-old baby girl, Kian. Given the freedom to choose, Pastor Reverend D. Florita willingly developed his promising career, all for the glory of God. Ladies and gentlemen, friends, our brothers and sisters, let us all welcome and stand and give honor to the man of God, Reverend Bishop Dr. Christopher D. Florita.
Thank you so much, Mom Oting. You may be seated. Good afternoon to everyone. I would like to greet our Acts Church, a happy church anniversary. 25 years of faithful ministry. Shall we give the Lord a mighty God? Amen. 25 years. Kagahapon lang, ha? So, I do not know. Pastor Bernie has prepared a short history of the church. No? Okay, that was 25 years ago. Pastor Burley is one of our young ministers who graduated from our Bible Institute. He came from Malangas, and then he traveled to Cebu to take up that spiritual renewal. Oh no, a school of ministry training. And then after that ministry training, he called me up and he said he would like to pursue his college studies here in Zamboanga. So during that time, I said, yes, that will be very great. Mahumanya yahang school. But then, was it a year after? 2 years after, he called me up again and he said, Pastor, I have a good news for you. And what is that? I'm getting married. He said he was getting married at the early age of 19. Okay, he was getting married at the age of 19. I started the ministry at the age of 21, but I got saved at the age of 20. So he is much younger than me. But I came over to Zamboanga City to formally install him as a pastor of the church here in Zamboanga. And we have our first family, Sister Gina and Brother Nonong, and of course si ilahang anak si Oji. I'm very sorry, si Oji. They were among the first family nga pag start yung sa church. We were having a small group in their very own home dito sa Camino Nuevo. And it's been 5 years since my last visit here, and I was very happy to be invited again. Just 2 weeks ago, we were having our 32nd National Convention sa Jesus Christ is Lord End Time Harvest Ministries, and we were able to come up with a figure that our church ministry international, we have 66 churches, local churches here nationwide. Pakpakan itong ginawa. 66. And then we have 2 churches in Australia and 1 church in Kota Kinabalu. And we were so happy gathering last in Cebu 2 weeks ago. And then Pastor Burley called me up and he said, I hope next year I will be able to join. Just hoping. All 2 years or the second year. I would like to personally invite you if you can join us in our national convention. National convention, ang End Time Harvest Ministries, magod, our vision is to plant churches, most especially in places where there are less churches or the gospel is being preached. No such a less privileged mga people in the area. Unlike mga big cities wherein almost in every corner, nanay mga churches. So ang vision ng heart sa JCIL, mawagin ang pag-plant of church in less privileged areas. So I'm so happy to look back 32 years after we were able to plant 66 churches nationwide. And our challenge this year will be to plant every district. That will be 10 districts to plant 1 church for the next year. So, kung natin mga 10 churches planted next year, we will have 76 churches by God's grace. And you know the good news? The good news is this. We just planted a church in Surigao Island. It's called Socorro Island. How many of you have been to Surigao? Surigao is one of the nicest place in Mindanao, na Bilipas Point ba. So we were able to plant a church last year, and we will be celebrating our first year next first week of December. Yeah, first week of December. On first year anniversary, and they were so courageous enough, bold enough, to accept the challenge that they will host for the 33rd National Convention. So, first year pa lang nila, ino na din sila, Pastor, if you will allow us, we will host the National Convention next year. So I go, we need to sit down and we need to talk about it first. So nag-plan out me, I have been there when we started the church. It's very nice place because it is an island. Yeah, ang mga neighboring islands niya, burak unspoiled, burak wala pa'y halos mga footprints. Ingon anak ka dito ng island. And our church there comes from a very prominent family na why nag-start na to. Ang mga kadaghanan sa mga tourist spots na yun sila'y investment. So when we had a chance and privilege to go there in Surigao, ako yun ika recommend if you can get the chance to be at the convention next year, it will be a wonderful place to go to. That will be next year, October 24, 25, and 26. So you can mark your calendar. And we will be extending invitations, most especially sa ato mga pastors, church leaders, and even church workers. You can join us for the National Convention. Amen. Praise God. So I would like to see you there. And then, karon ang ato church sa Acts is celebrating its 25th anniversary. And at the same time, Pastor Burley is also celebrating his 25th years old, happy birthday. Pastor Burley is celebrating his 44th birthday today. Ito pagpaka si Pastor Burley. Just in case you didn't know. So at the same time, Moran is 3-in-1. This is a church anniversary, church Thanksgiving, and Pastor Burley's happy birthday. Moran kapi, 3-in-1. So while we were in Cebu, the Lord implanted in my heart a certain message that I have been studying for quite a while. Pero during the time of my studies, I have seen that there are so many Christians today who have overlooked this very simple yet very important message that Christians or believers should understand. And I would like to share with you one of my favorite Psalms of David, found in Psalms 91. If you have read Psalms 91, you would come to understand that Psalms 91 is a great promise of God for a blessing and protection. Say blessing,
blessing
and protection.
And protection.
And you'll understand that Psalms 91 actually is a promise of God to every believer who believes in God and who believes in the power of God to experience a covering of protection. How many of us here this afternoon would like to raise up our hand and say, I would like to enjoy the covering of protection from God? Please raise up your hand. Amen. So every time I do a dedication, whether it is a property, a home, or a vehicle, I see to it that I will read Psalms 91. Because Psalms 91 is very powerful psalm coming from David from an experienced point of view. So this afternoon, we will be talking about Psalms 91, your covering and your protection. So I want you to sit back, and if you have your Bibles with you, I want you to turn your Bibles with me to the book of Psalms 91. So Psalms 91, let us try to read verses 1 to 4. Psalms 91, verses 1 to 4, in the name, He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. And all of God's people will agree and say, Amen.
Amen.
Now, this is a promise of blessing and protection in the book of Psalms. But the question will be, how many of us would like to enjoy such a blessing? And how do we enjoy such a blessing? And in verse 4, we have two important keywords that will help us understand how to enjoy the promise of blessing, the favor of God, and the protection of God. How many of us comes from a Catholic faith before, or a Catholic faith? Amen. Diba? Part of our church tradition, every Holy Week, we have what we call the Palm Sunday. Diba na Palm Sunday, na ito na ipa-bindeta ang ito ang mga lukay. And then, what do we usually do? I-fold na to, imo na to ng cross, ang uban, i-shape na to into some kind of a flower, and then, usually, what does the Catholic usually do? Kita nga mga Catholics, ato ibutang sa itong doorpost. Diba, tinoda? And then, we will believe that the devil will be expelled because of that cross and because of that palm. So, more than a traditional belief of the Catholics. But even though naatay may anak ang mga practices, but still napagihapoy mga unfortunate events that can happen inside the home. Pero how do we really enjoy such a covering and the protection of God? And here in the book of Psalms, we will find two important keywords that King David said. He said in verse 4, "He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler." Say, shield and buckler.
Shield.
So, kinikitawag na itong two important words. He said, cover. And he said, under his wings. So, it speaks of something. A covering and being under the covering. And because of that covering, and because you are under the covering, he will become your shield and your buckler. What about, it is very stupid enough when it rains and you go out with your umbrella, pero you will not open your umbrella. Diba? Kung panalitan you have your umbrella, you will not enjoy the protection from the rain unless you open the umbrella. And when you open the umbrella, you have to stay under the umbrella. And that is precisely what the king was trying to tell us. And he said, under thee with his feathers, cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. So it is very important that we stay under the covering of God. And how do we further expound this one? Romans chapter 13. Romans chapter 13, verses 1 and 2. Ingon pa nga rin si St. Paul. Everyone must submit, say the word submit.
Submit.
Everyone must submit himself to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist have been established by God. Consequently, he who rebels against the authority is rebelling against what God has instituted. And those who do so will bring judgment to themselves. The Apostle Paul mentioned about submission. When you say submission, ang pinaka simple explanation in it is to stay under the covering of that person who is in authority. Amen? So when you say submit, it means to say to be under the authority of that person, or the one who is delegated with the position. So, the Apostle Paul said in verse 2, God has, consequently, he who rebels against the authority is rebelling against God, against what God has instituted, and those who do so will bring judgment to themselves. So when a person fails to be under the authority or somebody's authority, they bring or invite judgment to themselves. So it is not really God who imposes the judgment, but it is they themselves. So the simple explanation will be, you will go out and it's raining and you have your umbrella open, but you do not stay under the umbrella. So you are exposing yourselves to the elements. So that is what the apostle was trying to say. And he said, you must, or everyone must submit to governing authorities. And it is very important, because when you stay under the submission of such an authority, you will enjoy the protection and you will enjoy the privileges of God's favor. So, under a covering means to be in submission to authority. So, when you want to be under the protection of God, you must stay under the authority of somebody. Bakit parang kulang yun? It is a place to be under the covering, or to be in submission to an authority. It is called a place of refuge, shelter, and it is a place of protection. I am very fond of fishing. This morning, kami ni Kuya Boyet, we went out to paseo and we went fishing. And everybody was surprised because my rod was bending so hard. Murang takot na yun nga isda ba? Kuya Boyet, no? So everybody was running to our place, kay nagbend naman ang hurag, and I was trying to reel in. And to our surprise, I caught a fish, but it was a starfish. Even during my college days, enjoying ko naman scuba diving, snorkeling, and I have a saltwater fish tank which can hold about 200 liters saltwater fish. And I have a specific a spot somewhere in our area na ato ko mag-catch home. Kaya itawag na itong mga coral fish because they are very colorful. But to my surprise, one particular week, when I went there, nanay mga, itawag na itong mga batay daga, nanay mga tanol. Yan sila, sir, dili na pwede pakuhaan nun eh. Ikaw ano man. And so, because we have converted this place as a fish sanctuary. Uy, dili na tayo pwede. And so, pag-sip, una-una, asa na magpumapuha o isda? So, yun ko pwede lang, magtanaw lang. So, pwede magtanaw, sir, pero dili na yun pwede ikapon. Dili na pwede hilagtan. So, while boating, ang ako na lang mahimo is just to watch the fish, but I cannot touch it anymore because it is under the protection of the government authority. Kaintende? So, ako, I am a fan of fish. I have my fish aquarium, but I cannot touch the fish because it was under the protection of the government. And that is how I understand authority. When God sets authority over us, God sets them as a person of authority to preserve and to protect us. Amen? So, when we are under the authority of somebody, when we submit to the authority of that somebody, we are actually submitting ourselves under the protection, under the favor, and under the blessings of God. And that is what the Apostle Paul was trying to say. Let everyone be submit to an authority. So everyone is being encouraged by the Apostle Paul. Na kinahanglan we will be under the submission of somebody. Okay, it is a place of divine favor. Psalms 91, let us go back. Ingo pa nga rin sa Psalms 91. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. And I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I will trust. But who is the one under the shadow of the Almighty? Because Psalms 91 speaks of somebody who is under the shadow of the Almighty. Who is that person? That person is the one who submits himself to the governing authorities, or what we call a divine authority. Let us take Adam and Eve as an example. When God created the first couple, God gave them the privilege to enjoy the beauty of the creation of God. Tama? So, they need not to work, they need not to plant, they need not to plow, and everything that they need, they can enjoy in the garden. Until one day, something happened. All these privileges, nawala na. Because of what? Because of sin. And how did sin came in? Through disobedience. The failure of submitting to the authority of God. Amen? So, Adam and Eve, they enjoyed the glory of God, the provision, the protection, health, and life. When they sinned by disobedience, the first thing that they did was to cover themselves. And isn't it very interesting that when Adam and Eve tried to cover themselves, they covered themselves with leaves. And yet God was angry. And He said, who told you that you were naked? And He said, the snake told us that we are naked. So God instructed them to change the covering because it was not the proper covering that they need after they have faith. So God instructed them to sheepskin. I mean animal skin, sorry. It was an animal skin. Dili proper kuno nga ang covering, the covering of their shame ang gamiton katong mga fig leaves. But instead it should be an animal skin. And after Adam and Eve, naaslay duha ka anak. Kisa pa ilang duha ka anak? Okay, si Batman o si Robin. Si Abel o si Cain. And we know the entire story na these two brothers had a quarrel. Why? Because one offering was accepted and one offering was denied. And the offering that was accepted, whose offering was it? Kan Abel. Si Abel by profession is what? A hunter. Diba? A shepherd. He was a man of the field. Si Cain is the man of the field. Si Abel, a hunter. Si Abel was a hunter, and si Cain was a man of the field. Okay, let me check. Okay. When both of these brothers made an offering, one offering was accepted. Which offering was accepted? The offering that was conducted by Abel. It was in form of what? Animals. But for Cain, he was offering the produce of the land, ang iyang mga fruits, and it was not accepted. But the question is this, why was it God was angry with the offering of Cain? Ang atong usual explanation is this, tungod kay si Cain wala magud mag-offer with his heart. And who are we to judge? Mayong tao nga si Abel was making the offering out of the fat, meaning out of the animal. But si Cain nag-offer dili kuno out from his heart. That is why it was rejected. But in a theological explanation, we can understand through what God was dealing with Adam and Eve. When Adam and Eve sinned against God, ang ilang shame was being exposed. They tried to cover their shame with the leaves. But God rejected that, and God instructed them na ilang kunong covering should be made of animal skin. Busa di ito, ang offering ni Cain was not accepted because it was from the vegetation of the land. And kang Abel was accepted because it comes from the animal. So no wonder why when the perfect offering was made in form of Jesus, si Jesus kuno is the substitute of the perfect Lamb of God. Okay, do you understand? So it means to say, when we talk about fruit of the land or the produce of the land, it speaks of our personal effort. There is in no way we can meet the favor of God in our own effort. Dili pwede sa atong paningkamot, dili pwede sa atong kaugalingon nga strength, makuha nato ang favor sa God. Ang favor of God should be through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Because He became the perfect sacrifice or the perfect Lamb of God. So, Jesus Christ, when Abel and Cain made the offering, ang i-accept sa Ginoo was the offering made by Abel. Pero we know the entire story nga nagselos si Cain and he murdered his own brother. And that's the beginning of what we call a very, very cruel death made by the other brother. So, makita na to, nga ang sin became even more grievous during the time after sa lineage ni Adam and Eve hantud sa kang Abel ug sa kang Cain. Let us try to see what Job has to say in chapter 36 verse 11. Inga pangari, if they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity. And this quote was spoken by Job after he had recovered from katong grabbing a disaster of trials in his life. In chapter 36, he came to understand through a message from God na ang prosperity of the days will only come by obedience to God. So if we want to enjoy favor from God, if we want to enjoy blessings from the Lord, we must be under obedience to God. Amen? Amen. We must be under the submission and in obedience to God. There is freedom in submission, but there is bondage in rebellion. Come to think about it. When a person is in submission and in obedience, there is great favor that shall come his way. But when a person starts to rebel, na yun ang itawag na to o bondage that will happen in his life, or that will happen in his life. Wala pa ko kakita o mga rebelde nga din ayahay ang ginabuhay. Isn't it true? Kadaghanan sa mga rebelde, magtago-tago sa bukid, magtago-tago o kaasa magsuok-suok. Ako pa nahibawan, ang uban ng mga rebelde, gakauna ng upupras. O niya, kana na lang mga trapal o tulga na lang may lahang himo nga raincoat o jacket. Why? Because they are in rebellion. Na nakaroon ang operation tukhang. Tukhang ba yung mga rin? Ang kanang operation na tukhang, ang katong dili mo submit sa authority, luway ang ilahang life. Magsili silang tabo-tabo. Ang uban, 6 feet under the ground. Why? Because they are in rebellion. Makita na to, ha? Bisan in our politics today, makita na to, kinsa na ang murag inclined to the rebellious side. Unya, miserably yun termi ang ilahang kinabuhi. Because there is no blessing in rebellion. But there is always blessing in obedience. Amen? There is always blessing in submission to authority. Authority has three important points that we must understand. Number one, all authority originates from God. Tanang authority, gikan sa Ginoo. And it is God who appoints all rulers, whether the ruler is good or the ruler is bad. Whether the king is good or the king is evil. God appoints all rulers. Number three, to rebel against those in authority is actually equivalent to rebellion against God. So come to understand these three important points in understanding authority. What is sin? We have to understand first, what is sin? Ang sin ko no, sutipa, 1 John chapter 3, verse 4. Everyone who sins breaks the law. In fact, sin is lawlessness. So according to John, ang explanation ko no sa sin is lawlessness. What is lawlessness? Ang lawlessness ko no is the condition of being without, under an authority because of ignorance of it, or because of violating it. Kanang mga tao nga dili gusto bitaw nga diktahan, mga tao nga dili gustong sultian, gustong magtuman sila ang gusto, they will always end up miserable. And that is what John was trying to say. And he said, everyone who sins breaks the law. In fact, sin is lawlessness. Salamat ang Pastor Berlin, yung nag-lawyer. So, tunduan ta niya how to be always under the authority of God. So, sin is to go against delegated authority or to be in submission to God. And lawlessness is the condition of being without, under an authority because of ignorance of it or because of violating it. Matthew chapter 24. Matthew 24 speaks of the last days. Unsay mahitabo in the last days. And because of lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. In the last days, na kunoy itawag na to lawlessness. People refuse to be under such authority. E bawa na to ngano magpa under magkus authority ana nga presidente pagkabisaya. Nya balikasan kayo. Nga sa nahambugiro na nga presidente isu kayo. They refuse to be under such authority because they don't like the president. But there is nothing that we can do because the president, whether he is good or he is bad, he is appointed by God. Amen? And there is nothing that we can do. Whether we like him or not, we have to be under his authority because we are his people. Amen? Ang root cause kuno of deception or massive lawlessness, according to James chapter 1 verse 22, ingon pa siya, be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. So a person who refuses to be under the authority of somebody is a person who is greatly deceived. Mayon kag deceive, it means to say you have been tricked into believing a lie. So when a person believes that he needs not to be under any authority, is actually deceived by Satan, and he is not in any form of protection. Two important questions. What is the root cause of deception? And why does deception or lawlessness go rampant in the last days? According to Matthew and Hill, because the love of many will grow cold. Nawala kuno ang ilahang love. And the love that is being defined here is actually the agape love. There are different definitions of love. Eros, Phileo. Eros, Phileo. Eros is love for the opposite sex. Phileo is the love for the brethren. Narcissus is the love for self. But the agape love is the love or the God kind of love. Okay? So, let me define it first. When you say Eros love, love for the opposite sex, it is always conditional. I love her, I love him because he is tall, dark, and handsome. I like her because she is white, you know, blonde hair, and sexy. So, conditional. Pero kung dili nagali tall, dark, and handsome, never mind. Kung dili nagali sexy nga, 36, never mind. It is always conditional because it is love for the opposite sex. But how about the phileo love? Love for the brother. Bisan, iksuon pa kami. Blood brothers good, mag-away pa. Di ba tinod na? I grew up with three of my sisters, sige ni og away, hangtod we grew mature. Pagkadagko na namo, ay hapa namo, nasaktan na eh, mga bata, ginday tawa. Pero nato me, because we are already mature karon, na wala na may conflict, nakakihapon. May mga, ikaw na siya palit sa vitamins ni mama. So nakakihapon yung mga, itawag na to conflicts, pero it doesn't necessarily mean na away na, grabe na away, pero nakakihapon ng misunderstanding, even though you are brothers. Amen? Brothers in the church, nakakihapon. Namagaling ang brother nga bloodline, so much more na brotherhood in the church. Pero how about the agape love? The agape love is unconditional. Whether you are handsome, you're beautiful, you are loved by God. You may not be handsome, you may not be beautiful, you are still loved by God. If you are a good person, you are loved by God. If you are not good or not very good, you are still loved by God. Amen? If you are a righteous and holy person, you are loved by God. But if you are a sinner, still you are loved by God. Because the love of God is unconditional. Amen? Kita nga tao, conditional na nga itong love. I love him because he likes me. I love him because he likes me. I like her because she likes me also. So naay mga condition. Pero when we learn about negative things about a person, ang atong love will start to matainted na dayon. Dili na dayon ma-perfect na atong love. Busa, ang Matthew 24, i-define na niya, ingon siya, because of the lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. So sa ito pa, nawala ang unconditional love. Ang love na na-exercise will be Eros love, Phileo love, o Narcissus love. Kanang bugi points, Narcissus love, love for self, selfie. Di ba? Mga Narcissus love na. Yeah, but then selfie. Daghan kayo ng mga klase ng love. But where is the agape love? Asa naman? It is all because of the lawlessness in the last days, the agape love will grow cold. Ina mo neighbor, kinahanglan, let us give up the agape love. Amen? Second Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 7. For the secret power of lawlessness is already at work. Meaning, the power of Satan is already at work even in our time today. And Satan is trying to deceive so many people that they will live in a life of lawlessness. Dili magpasulti. Ingon sa nanay nga, ayaw paglakaw kay 6 o'clock na, gabi na. Ah, maglakaw yun. Kung sirad ang napuntahan, sa bintana mo lukso. Nga naman, that's lawlessness. 2 Corinthians 11 verse 3, but I am afraid just as Eve was deceived by the serpent's cunning craftiness. So Satan is very crafty in deceiving people. And there are so many people being deceived by Satan today, believing that they can rise above their authority. Kaya gitawag na to o mo usurp of authority above an delegated authority. And that is the craftiness of Satan. If you will read Ezekiel about Lucifer and in the book of Isaiah, you will come to understand na si Lucifer the eye, he loves himself so much. And he was deceived into believing that he can rise even greater than God. I can be like the Most High. And that is what he believes. And there are so many people today, not only inside the church, but even in our offices, in our classroom, who believes that they are greater than their boss, who believes that they are more intellectual and more intelligent than their parents. Ay, si nanay, grade 3 lang na. Ako, college graduate ko. Ay, nanay, hilo. Grade 3 ka na, nanay. So, naay mga anak na ingon ana ang mga attitude. They thought because they are educated, they are more intelligent than their parents and they are more wiser than their parents. And that is deception. Whether they are well-educated or not, ang atong parents, we are still bound to submit to their authority because they are our parents. Amen? Okay, next. Oh, children, maminaw ah. Lawlessness will be rampant because people will not love the truth and refuse to submit to authority. To love truth means to love obeying it. If we love the truth, we should also love obeying the truth. Not just hearing the truth, but obeying the truth. Genesis 4, verses 1 to 6. Ingat pangari. And Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. And she again bare his brother Abel. And Abel was a keeper of the sheep. Tama, keeper of the sheep. But Cain was the tiller of the ground. In process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. And Abel, he also brought of the firstlings of his flock and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering. But unto Cain and to his offering, he had not respect. And Cain was very wroth, and his countenance fell. And the Lord said to Cain, why art thou wroth, and why is thy countenance fallen? And that is one important question. Why did God accept the offering of Abel and not of Cain? It is all because of the kind of offering that they were presenting to God. God was always requiring what we call animal offering. And an animal offering, animal is a substitution of our sin. Now, this is how the priest exercised what we call the law of exchange. Before they will slaughter the sheep, they will always look for a perfect lamb. Kanang karnero. So, i-check man nila ang karnero, ang kanang sheep. I-check nila, dili buta, dili kabang, dili piang. Kinahanglan perfect. And what the priest is going to do is to lay his hand on that sheep before it is being slaughtered. And the priest will pronounce this. Ingon ang priest, all the sins of my people will be upon this sheep. And by the time I will kill this sheep, the sin of the people will go with the sheep. And the perfection of this sheep will go to the people. And that is what we call the principle of exchange. When Jesus died, the sin of the people was upon Jesus. He was a man who knew no sin, but was made to sin, that we might become the righteousness of God. So when the high priest lay his hand upon the sheep before the sheep is being slaughtered for an offering, the priest will pronounce all the sins of the people. And then the perfection of the sheep will be transferred to the people, and they will live a righteous life for 1 year. Every year, money and ritual. But then in the book of Hebrews, see, Paul explained it very clearly that God has had enough of the sheep offering. He was looking for the perfect sacrifice that will end all sacrifice. And that was in the person of Jesus Christ, the perfect Lamb of God. And that is why even though Jesus committed no sin, but all the sin of the people, the sins of the people was imputed upon him, that when Jesus died, our sins died with him. Amen? And the righteousness of Jesus is pronounced upon the people. Mona nga, we are the righteousness of God in him. Amen? So, when the sheep is being pronounced as the perfect sacrifice, the slaughter na nila, the perfection of the sheep will transfer to the people. That is how it happened. Busa, dili man maihaw ang vegetable, ang mga garden product, dili man maihaw kayo may blood. Gawas lang kung kato. Pakuan na. Kasi tawag ini, watermelon, kainig anak ni mo, pulas na mo agas. Pero, dili mo fit sa gusto sa Ginoo. So it has to be an animal sacrifice. And that is why ang offering ni Cain was not accepted by God. Okay? So, nasaktan na to? Okay, next. There are two ways his authority manifests. Two ways the authority of God manifests. One, through direct or inherent authority. And second is by delegated authority. Kana gitawag na itong inherent authority, meaning gihatag directly sa Ginoo, gi-inherit sa iya. Meaning, imuhang submission is direct to God. But there are four areas of authority that we must also pay respect. And this is called four delegated authorities, delegated by God. Which are, number one, social authority. Number two, civil authority. Number three, the family authority. And number four, church authority. These are four authorities of our life. When we talk about social authority, if we are an employee, we are subject to the authority of our boss. Kumingon na tong boss, overtime. Awa kita mahimo dia. Kanino ang boss ug kada
boss. Now we schedule date ako missis.
Adire or else ala resign na lang.
Adire pwede.
So we have to be subject to such an authority. If we are a student, kinsa man ato authority? Our teacher. So wala pa estudyante nga sige kating classes nga nalipay ang teacher. Pagsakira, no? Pagsakira. So kung panalitan isa ka ka-estudyante na gusto ka mo pass sa imuhang subject, bahala gamay nga grado, pero hindi ka, ma'am, may I erase the board? Ma'am, may I sweep the floor? Kinahanglan, simsip yun ka sa imuhang teacher, haram. May na lang, bisan ka luoy, makapasar ka. Oh? Yung may nga manday na ang teacher, ay, kabuutan na ini nga bata, eh, 74, 75 na lang. So, nakapasar, pasang awa, may tawag nila. So, naagyoy, nagigitawag na to grace to those who are in submission. Amen? We have Andrew here. O panalitan si Andrew boss yan, na kahuman na iyahang employee, bright kayo si Toto, very intelligent, magna cum laude graduate. Boss, this is what we should do. Yun hindi boss, according to my study, yun hindi dapat na kabuhaton. Ah, impress Andrew. Pero here is an employee, si Burley. Ah, boss, unsay pwede na ako mahimo, boss. Ah, boss, unsay pwede siya boss ako, boss. But then, even though he may be excellent in his grades, pero every time the boss commands him to do something, ay, hindi ko, sikwa na na, boss. Hindi ko na, boss, kaya mahuga akong kamot. Mahuga ako ang ako ang jeans. Dili ko, init kayo na to, boss. Sikwa na lang. Magsiyo yung reklamo. What do you think the boss will do? You're fired! So, yun. Pero here is a guy, he may not be as intellectual as the first one. He may not be as intelligent as the first one, but he has the right attitude. Yes, boss. Okay, boss. Ay, problema, boss. Tanang nga sugo, oo. Pero tinood na, we love to be with people nga kanapitaw ang dili negative. Bisan gani sa barkada. Ay, manan ang tao kuan. Manan ang tao. Kasi ka ng mga fireworks, karong December, hindi mo, ikot mo lang ninyo, tas firecracker, mga sumog ta, mga kuwan ninyo ta. Di ba, nai, sometimes in our group, in our barkada, na agi mag-devil-devil, kana bitaw ang murag, mo ay mo break, permi sa unity, permi bitaw na ay negative attitude, ay mag-swimming ta, ay, mga lumos niya ta. Ay, mag-konta, mag-konta, mga mag-tapitos ko, ay, ma-full poisoning mo niya ta. Sama dengan klase ini, sudut magsabot na din ang barkada, ayok sunting isi ko. Negative ka itong natawag. We really don't like such kind of attitude, kaya negative na spirit pa. Tama? And I strongly believe, even ana sa perception sa Ginoo, He is not requiring us to be very intelligent, very wise, but what He loves about a person is the attitude. Amen?
Amen?
Somebody who is always under an authority. How many of you are parents here? Okay, parents. Naay mga anak. Okay, kung naay mga anak, like, I have three. I would like to say na I love my three kids equal. Kamu, yun anak ko? Ma'am, no? Equal. Ilan ko? How many children do you have? Four. Equal yun. Ah. Pero tinuod, as we pronounce, equal yun sila. Pero every time we do something, sometimes one of our kids is always negative. Sumingon din, kuya, ay nagsaban ko. Kita na lang magkuyo kaysa nakitos kuya ba? Mas ganahan na itong kuyukon katong anak na diin, kung saya ito isugo, kung saya ito isunti mo tuman. Pero nagalitay anak, na pirmi yung negative, eh, gusto ko ato, hindi na din ako kuyukun. Hindi na din ako kuyukun. Kaya, padroon mo. Di ba tinood na? Ganahan ta magkuyong o bata na ka ng tabi na kuyukun, ka ng way attitude, hindi ka reklamo, kada taon-taon na lang, gutom ko, gutom ko. Bitong ka, nas ka. Kaya ka gutom. Kaya pag human na itong karon, palin ko hindi, gusto ko ato. Wapagalit akabot sa itong paingnan, daghan ka gitutlo, gusto ko yun. nagapata sila tanan. Pero whether we like it or not, naagyun tay favorite. Kung kinsa tong favorite na to, katong inikuyog na to, walay nagang reklamo. So, kamo mga anak, nga natin, hey, kung gusto mo mahimong mong favorite, ayaw nagang reklamo. Amen? Kung sa isugo ni nanay, umitatay, tuwa na yun. Amen? Ikabot tatay, hatag dahil sinilas tayo, sinilas tayo. Kaya nga naman, naagin na sa atong heart. And that is also in the heart of God. Any children na tanang na itong na always under the obedience and the command of God, favorite na niya, although favorite niya kanan. Amen? So we have what we call four delegated authorities, and let me go quickly. One is social. Other one is the civil authority, which is the government. Presidente, maganahan ta sa presidente o dili, maganahan ta sa atong mayor o dili, maganahan ta sa atong barangay captain o dili, maganahan ta sa ato ang mga barangay tanod o dili, what you tell me, we should subject ourselves to such an authority. And then of course, the family authority, say family authority. This is a true story, something happened. Listen to this. One particular child asked the permission sa iyang parents na mumpuyog siya among his friends na magkuan lagi daw ng somewhat like mag-beach, mag-outing, mag-picnic. Mutana tayo ng, it was the father, mutana ang father. Asa man mo mag-picnic? Ay, murag diha ka mag-tingali sa door. Dili, asa, David. Pagkahibaw sa father nga layo di ay, niya murag, mutake pa o ka ng rough na ride, ingon ang papa, no, dili ka dapat mag-uyog, kahit ka ng area, rough kayo na, disumbog sakay, what time will you be back? Siyempre, tingali sa'yo, kung saan na sa'yo, layo mo kahit tumiyahin on. Niya, saan niyo, pag sa'yo, uli, siya basta kayo sa'yo, layo. In short, ingon yun ang tatay, no, dili ka pwedeng mag-uyog. All the friends will be in that outing. So, from the behind of the parents, hindi din siya kung tipos. Puyog din siya nato sa ilang outing. And you know what? This is what happened. Napuno na ng bus ang ilang isakyan. Ang katong group ng mga barkada, dito nagsakay sa taas. Naiguog. Kung saan kakahoy bitaw mo while the bus was moving. Sa ang tanan, nagsiyo tanaw na mayroon, oy kahoy, paghubo siya mayroon, asa! Naigo siya sa kahoy na hagko. Kunya, huwag yun tayong kadisgrasyahan niya. Ihila umayo ang papa, kay ang papa, huwag mo siya mag-expect na iya ang anak ni Kuyo niya. Naniingon tayo ng papa, ako mo yung iingan ng ulang na bigin ng Kuyo, pero hindi Kuyo niya. And in my personal realization, wala na ko sundi iya papa. Tingnan ko, na-expose ang iyahang anak sa danger because of rebellion. Wala may approval sa parents, ni gawas siya outside the covering of the parents. So, babae mo to, she exposed herself to the danger. Ang sundi pa, they impose judgment to themselves. What is sulti ni Paul sa Romans 13? Tinood yun eh. Daghan sa mga bata na who are in rebellion sa parents, kundi madunggaban, makadunggap. Diba tinood? Kundi mo ospital, mamintiryo. Ganun eh. Because of rebellion. Kundi maburos, maburusan. And it's true, and it's a reality today. So we have to understand that any form of rebellion, you expose yourselves to the enemy. You expose yourselves to the danger. That is why Psalms 91 is something Christians should understand. He who dwells under the shadow of the Almighty shall abide under the... He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Meaning you will stay under the protection of God when you are in obedience or submission to authority. Yeah. The fourth one is the church authority. We are all under a church authority. And our church authority is always our pastor. Amen? There was a camp meeting from Cagayan de Oro. We were going to Itil probably, was it? So, tanan ng mga youth campers, akong inan, dungan tatanan, paingon nga to sa camp, dungan sa tantanan, pagpauli, ha? Ingon na, yes, pastor! Ah, sige, sabot na ba? So, off we go, paingon nga to sa camp meeting. After 4 days, akong inan, okay, everybody pack up. Early in the morning, biyahin ta, dungan tagbalik. Na, din, dungan sa puwan. Pastor, kanang pwede ko magpabilin? Ingo dili, nagsabot na tantaan, nga kuyog tapaingon nga to, kuyog sa tapagpauli. Saan ko pagtubag ni mga parents? Ingo di siya, nanamship na mong kundaan. Nga pwede rin ako magpabilin. Asa mo ka magpabilin? Kay naamang ko yung friend ko na di sa camp na pastayin ko niya overnight. Kay kuyog lagi ko na, ingo dili gil kung pwede ana. Dili gil pwede. Pastor, okay rin lagi. In short, we insist gil. Grabe na mga argument. Lalis ni, pero dako naman. Huwag akong awayin mo, sukol niya sa ako. Nakuhunahunang kalaib ako din eh. Ikaw, asin eh. Hatagan di ka warning. Basta kung ako'y mapangutanon, dili yung ka pwede magpabilin. Pero naarasin mo ang choice kung magpabilin mo o dili. Basta ako musuti, dili yung ka magpabilin. Bahala na mo, pabilin ko kung ulit mabitaw ko. Ah, sige, sige, uli naman ka. And this is what happened. Pagpamauli na sa grupo, anong dahil siya, ay, sister, sister, kanina ako ang mga bulingon, ang iyang bag. Mga bulingon niya, ako kayo nga ba? Yan kipa daw? Bulingon ko daw di, eh, harun, muanto ko na siya na ito, kasa to siya muanto, kamay na lang ko nga bag, yan kita. Kasi, ako mo kayo na, tere, ako mo kayo na, tere, isa tiri lagi, okay na lagi ni, total, inignaw ni mo, mo na bitaw na yun na, isakay lang ni mo, kapila kong bag. In short, di karga yung kapila niyang bag. Pag-abot sa Cagayan de Oro, tungkol sa kakapoy na pagpanganaog, natural, ikaw magpipit, yung kayo mo siguro ni mong bag. Nalimot ang yung gibinlan, yung gibinlan na isang lain bag, ang nabili ng bag. Pag ulit niya, a day after, isa asa akong bag, ha, na, ang mong bag, kagahapon, pala madiskarga sa bus. Kita pa sa isa, ako muna kinakusgan na si Mina, to araw pa dito na man. Hilak ni siya umayo, hilak ni siya umayo. Pagkawang saan, saan ay niya ang ikakuptan? Hingga din siya, pastor, si sister ko ang nitaw, ang iyahang bag, wala ba diskarga sa bus? Ako din ipatawag, dali, 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 dali. Unsay istorya na ko ni mo before I left. Unsay ang sultin ni mo, tama na pastor, tama, 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 tama. Hilak ni siya umayo. And it made her realize that every rebellion has a price to pay. Amen?
Amen.
Kada rebellion na aging price to pay. Muna yung soon, we should be very keen and we should be sensitive. Unsay mga sulti sa atong pastor, unsay sulti sa atong mga authority, we should be obedient enough because it is for our own good. Kung gusto ta mong excel, kung gusto ta nga mo ma-promote, kung gusto ta ma-favored by God, always stay under the submission of authority.
Amen?
Amen? Pagpaka na ito, Ginoon. Ladies and gentlemen, the book of Psalms 91 is a wonderful exposition of the idea and the understanding of David, how it is to live under the favor of God. And we have these 4 delegated authorities. And sad to say, many people today doesn't have an understanding of such an authority. Daghan mga young people karon wala kasabot kung sa authority sa ilang ginikanan. Sometimes because ang ilang ginikanan, kamay man lang grado, sa ilang ginikanan, grade 1 lang, niya sila, college graduate, professional na. Unya sayo na lang dahil nila magsukol silang ginikanan. Usahay kahit tumod ang ilang ginikanan, igulang na. Wala na bitaw, wala na bitay, wala na kaya. Niya sila, ayahay na ilang kinabuhi. Dili na nila hatagan gani og respect ang ilang ginikanan. Usahay kay kung ilang ginikanan, kanang mga farmers lang, mga mag-uuma lang. Niya sila kay doktor na, engineer na, dagko na ang mga ngaram ko, ipa-shut up na lang ilang, shut up nanay, shut up! Ipa-shut up na lang ang nanay, ang nanay sa... Palitan sa akong vitamins, shut up na lang po yun eh. Pero sa tabaklo na makagabat din ang nanay. Hello. Usahay ang ato ang boss. Sayon na sa kay balot ang atong boss ko. Ang boss ko yun. Minos kayo din ba? Hina kayo mga decision making. Hina kayo planning. Saan yung ato ang boss ko yun? And every time we talk negative behind their back, we are taking away the protection from ourselves. We are exposing ourselves to some kinds of elements na nganong bigligtad kakaangat sa ating kinabuhi. And I have seen so many people na intellectual, very efficient, hardworking, pero nganong man din mag-excel. Na-promote na ang uban, pero sino walang paghihapon kaka-promote? 8 years na sa kumpanya, ang uban, pag 2 years, 3 years pa lang, na-promote na sila, walang gihapon. Kaya nga naman, because they have an attitude problem. Sa katuling, naangang sa kanan eh. Tinugdog ko atong driver sa forklift, sa trabaho na sa una. Tuling na, nasa ka, nakita ta sa ground floor, karon sa fourth floor, nakita ka sa ta. Asa mo katuling? Diba si sir? Kanan, nalipyo ko sa kwan, sir. Ha? Diba? Forklift driver, kamabot ka sa fourth floor. Na-member ka na ba sa SSS? Iyon eh, ay, bugay na, boss. 12 years na po member sa SSS. Ano ba ka na? Sige, suroy-suroy. Sige, ikaw ang katawa o mayo. Kay, pero na sa kahiers, pero ang itya mo angat sa ilahang kinabuhi. Why? Because of attitude problem. Na ay mga estudyante, bright magpunta. Pero nga nung pag 6 years, 7 years, 8 years sa college, usahay ang ilahang maestro, classmate nila, papasaron na lang kaya ron makahuman. Nga naman, because attitude problem. So church, how do we relate to our pastor? Not because our pastor is younger than us or members. Dili nagpasabot na mas natay authority over them. Because what they have is a God-delegated authority. Behind the authority of the pastor is the authority and the anointing of God. Amen? And we should learn to respect not the person, but the delegated authority of God. Amen? So this afternoon, this is what I want us all to do. We will have a short reflection. And let us try to check around us if there are any forms of disobedience we might have committed against authority, delegated authority such as civil authority, social authority, which reminds me, kapalo mo nga nung si Manny Pacquiao until now, kasi di og excel, kay si Fred Roach nagsuntig yun. Si Manny kuno bisan as intellectual and as influential as he is, hangtod karon taas lang yapo ko niya ang respect kay Fred Roach. You remember the first famous na the Jungas boxer? Kinsa ba to? Bad boy of the Jungas, General Santos? Bubura kayo itong iyang stardom, si Navarrete, Rolando Navarrete. Si Rolando Navarrete, great, such a great athlete. Pero problema na itong Navarrete, alahubog during sa training, inigabot sa training, bubog. Kasi mag-overnight, daghan ko nung kaya itong kapangkwano ng mga prostitute. Daghan ko nung kaya itong kaaliro ng mga prostitute. Kung yan, sige, nagsuti ang coach niya. Saan ni mo Rolando pag-excel? Sa kini, hatag sa Diyos, di ka kong gahong. Nana, ang iya ko nung gahong, hatag sa Diyos. Iyang gisukat ang umor siyang kontra, di tulog siya. Pero nahawa si Manny Pacquiao. Kung nga lang ni-excel, kitungon, kabalo siya mo respect sa authority na naasaya. Amen?
Amen?
And there are so many athletes na mahibalaan na ito na nang-excel tungkol kay maayo ilahang attitude towards ilahang authority. Amen?
Amen.
Karon, there are some people also inside the church. I experienced this before. Yeah, every time we have this Sunday service, may isa sa akong musician. Yeah, humalila o tuktok. Mugawas, kaya mag-snack. Mubalik na, hindi ka humana sa service, kaya mag-tuktok na po. Nana din ang sumbong sa ako, Pastor, si Juan di ka, Pastor? Huwag ka kabantay. Ikutin mo. No, every time na mag-preach, naku, wala. So, he confront. He said, Pastor, kadugog naman po ang iyong mga walik, Pastor. Kadugog na daw siya sa akong walik. Right, ni na bata. Right, ni. Kaya mo po, kawali na doon ka na yan. And I came to realize na the ICR, na church happened na before. Naghanang ang mga churches kayaan na lukso-luksohan. Ihatag pa lang ang text, Psalms 91. Ay, kadungog na po, anak. Matthew 24, ay, kadungog na po, anak. Kadungog na siya, pero eh. Dahil hindi na siya kapaginaw. Kung saan na hitabo, ako po hindi pa pahawa. I cannot share my pulpit with you. Because as musicians, you are ministers also. So, kinapangin ako siya. Kailangan attitude. So, bisan pa ako, bukay na tanga na Christian o bakulan tanga Christian, we should realize this. We should understand how important the anointing of a pastor is in our life. Amen? If you are in a point na you need to make important decision and you cannot come up with a wise one, why don't you approach your pastor? Pastor, I am in this situation. I need your wisdom. May kung sa pastor, I have no knowledge about such a situation, but we will pray about it. Nay, makatabang ni mo pray. Tama? Amen? Amen. So, panayitan na akay in a certain situation, don't hesitate to approach your pastor because he's your spiritual covering. Amen? Amen? And don't you ever try to attempt to dishonor him by talking behind his back. Why? Because he is your spiritual authority. Gani mo ingon kang, if ever you are to love somebody in your life next to your parents, it should be your pastor. Amen? Amen. Next to your parents. Of course, na kay asawa, na kay imuhang banal, love din mo. Pero isa sa mga circle of people na you should treat so dearly in your life should be your pastor. I remember my young people married a Korean guy. Kasi yung tayo sa pastor, kanang mag-minyo na ako, pastor. Oo, mo ba? Kisa na yung minyo? Hindi ko mong kukabantay nga na siya ay boyfriend sa congregation. Kasi siya, ang boyfriend na Korean. Hoy, nalang yung boyfriend na Korean. Hindi siya, oo, pastor, 2 years na minyo. And then, he will be coming over to when you understand the position of your pastor. You have to understand that he serves God not because of money or not because of any pleasure. Kung pananglitan, mag-share mo sa inyong blessings sa inyong pastor, your pastor will deeply appreciate it. Bisan pa 10 peso lang. 10 peso lang. Bisan pa, you will invite him for a snacks niya, star margarine lang, anay na sukar, nakalitan na yung Pepsi. Limay na kaya na ang pastor. Ako, limay na sa kaya ko, anak. Mga simple gestures of gratitude. Ayaw mo mag-una-una na ang pastor, kinahanglan lang. Tako, want you kayo to appreciate him. No. Simple as it is. Appreciate your pastor. Amen? For a job well done. Pastor Burley, I salute you. Happy birthday. Amen. Ayaw mo pag sa itawag ni kanang pagtihik sa inyong prayers for your pastor. When you go to sleep, if the Lord reminds you of your pastor, pray for your pastor. Because your pastor is praying for you, but there are only a few in the congregation who understands the importance of pastor for prayers for the pastors. If in any means there are time na diin, the Lord will convict you to visit your pastor. Di ka like, ay, ala, nagtagahan, hindi na ako palit, hindi na ako ang sliced bread. Wala mo din tao sa palay. Ay, ihatod ko ni kang pastor ang uban. Hello? You do that because every time you do a good gesture towards your pastor, you appreciate your pastor, you are doing also that towards God. Because he is a man of God with a authority delegated from God. Amen?
Amen.
Kung panalitan, one time, I was preaching about the reality of death. And I said, I used to believe that preparation for death is not any more important, but I came to realize that we are to prepare for death because it will come in a time that we less expect it to happen. So while I was talking to the congregation about this, a member in the congregation after the church service went up to me and he said, Pastor, I would like to share with you something that the Lord is telling my heart. I go, what is it, Ate? And then the Lord told me, napalitan ka o burial flag. A memorial plan. And then palitan ka o memorial plan. Kaya mamatay ka, Pastor, di na mag-uwali mong pamilya. Ako na, ikaw is naman. Sa Ginoo, pwede na akong mamatay. Pero, tinood yun do. And on my birthday, itagaanin ko niya o certificate o, sa mga, or a certificate of full payment, pagkatawa niya, certificate of, under the name of, kuan, transferable pag yun. Ako nga, o kisay mo una na to, pwede nila ko ihatag. It means, usahay, mga katawanan ako, mga utang, that it means something. Amen? Because today is our pastor's birthday, and I just feel that we also need to recognize the effort and the hardship, the dedication, the commitment of our pastor. He was a young guy, which I know long, long time ago. Pero among the mga students sa ako sa Bible school, ang pinakakiat kini. Dong, nanong lugay naman siya ka nakauli dong. Daghan isa kapit-kapitan. Gitan sa classroom, padungan mo uli. Ay, pinapaday siya kapit-kapitan. Mga extra curriculum activities. So, during sa time, young as he was during the time, I thought na wala kayo tumangsing in sa iyahang una-una ang importance sa ministry. But I realized na among sa iyahang mga badges, he is one of the excellent na mga student na he survived his and last daghan ng mga crisis na nandiyan. Ang uban went through also some crisis pero they give up easily. Pero si Pastor Burley, ipursu pa rin siya sa iyahang log. Ang hulinan ni ko na, are you sure? Kaya ni mo na mag-log? Di ba na nata sa grace yun? I feel that God is leading me to pursue my studies mo kwansya sa Lord. Ko, sige, you pray about it. Basta lang, dili lang mo i-conflict sa imuhang number one or first ni mo nga calling, which is the Lord's calling. Karon he is graduating by March. Mag-graduate na siya. Baka na kang ginawa. Yeah. So, thanks siya. Bar exam. And my Bible tells me that one of the functions of the Holy Spirit is to put into remembrance the things that you need to remember. So every time na nata sa question, difficult kayo, we need the Holy Spirit taba. Kaya lang nata ika-answer. Okay. Oh, may advantage sa mga Christian. Kaya maka, pangayaw bang taba, Holy Spirit taba. So, let us take the time to enjoy this night. And I would like to say, if ever there are areas in your life today in which you believe na naay slight exposure to elements because there is no covering in your life through social authority, civil authority, family authority, and church authority. This is the perfect time to come to God and say, Lord, forgive me for rebelling against my parents. Forgive me for my rebellion against my boss. Sige lang kong pandaot sa akong boss na upaw na lang ang iyong boss. Sige na kong daot. Sige na kong chismis. Pero Lord, forgive me. Lord, pasaylo ako. Sige na kong daot si Duterte. Ang presidente, sige na lang ako o boss nga to sa Facebook. So, if that is what you're doing, you ask for forgiveness and bring back the protection of God upon your life. Amen? Let us all stand.